Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop here, and welcome back to another episode of Gold Coast Aquarium. Today we're starting right at the entrance because there are a few little things I changed with the new aquatic DLC coming out just a few hours ago. The letters, the fonts, yes, amazing. There are, I think, three new fonts with this update. I think the update came out, but not with the pack itself, so you can get these for free. And before, I had these very sort of blocky custom-made letters made out of the plaster squares, and they didn't look very good, so I used the brand new, I think this is, let's see what font this is, the large font Noto G font, yep, and I put it on both sides, but we will come through here. Nothing new in here. I would like to add a gift shop. I finally decided that this is going to be where the gift shop is going to be, so that'll probably be next episode. Maybe build some, like, dolphin and penguin plushies. And nothing new over here, but in the main elevator room, we did a sort of upgrade to the axolotl tank, and we have Drax gutter pipe axolotls, which look amazing. We're in a sort of new age of gutter pipes instead of art shapes for making custom scenery. And another update, I think, was this the aquatic pack or the update itself? I don't remember, but we have some amazing new flexicolor rocks finally. Jesus, I know. But yeah, some cute little axolotls, some sort of red deserty themed rocks, and a little agave in the left corner. And go up the elevator, and this is where things start to get brand new. Boom. So I finally decided what this winery building will be called. This is the Sheephead Trotteria. It was originally Sheephead Winery, but in Bronation, Mike called it a trotteria one day, and I was like, oh yeah, that's what these are actually called. So I renamed it to Sheephead Trotteria. If you don't know what a sheephead is, it is a pretty common sport fish here in California. They're super scary looking, just monster fish. Wouldn't want to meet one in a dark alley if you want to look those up. But yeah, we added a bunch of little cypresses up front for the sort of Tuscany feel and some little log benches. And I also changed the buttons on the elevator with some of the new rods and bracket pieces we have from the past couple updates. And yeah, it's a cowberry bush up front just to make it look a little more naturalistic. Because before it was looking a little bit kind of empty, a little bit sort of bland looking with like just the plaster, but I think the sort of foliage draped on top gives it a lot of life. And nothing down here, and sort of nothing on this, there we go, nothing on the second story. I'm torn between adding seating or like sort of a little display cases maybe. I'm not sure, I'll leave that up to you guys, but we'll go back down. And this is the main outdoor seating area of this trotteria. We got some lights sort of attached to this main awning structure. I noticed this in a lot of sort of outdoor winery seating. They have like lanterns, but then they also have a lot of string lights. I thought it looked really cool. And then over here, to the left of the jelly cellar, we have a little gateway. It goes into a little staff area with the water treatment plant. Just so, before there was no backstage to this, it was just sort of empty woods. So now our little jelly cellar has all the filtration it needs. And over here, we have our Gold Coast Winery. Or not winery, this is the vineyard. This is the winery, that's the cellar, that's the vineyard. And we will zoom out here just to give it a good long look. And yeah, it's actually a really small vineyard. There are absolutely enormous ones like in the sort of central California area. But I'll show you how I did this. We used the Haribo wine bushes, and then I just threw in some electric fences all on a straight line with the wood fence beams in the middle, just so it didn't look too metallic. And yeah, it's pretty simple procedure. And then we have some lavender in the front, and then some of the smaller triator grass, so it looks more like they're growing different types of plants. And then over here, this is the main outdoor seating. You have a big awning in the middle, sort of a canopy, and this leads into the fireplace. sheephead trotteria. And they used this little Arctic log with the pine cones and leaves on it. I thought it looked super rustic and just kind of adorable. And then the fireplace, the little structure underneath is the Australian rods. And then I sunk the African fireplace in for the charcoal. And then for the fire itself, I used the Arctic lanterns and I just sunk those into the ground. And I just think this is super rustic and adorable. And I love it. Love it, I love it. But we will go back to daytime. This is like the peak hour, like 13, 14. And we have some craftsman lanterns up against the vineyard. These are the East Asian ones, but this is as close to a craftsman lantern as we have. And then some custom tables, and little tasting tables in the middle. And then these barrels are by Just Goron, but he released a colorable version, so that was super useful, just improving the area's color palette. And we have the little century plants up top for some little planters, because there are very few good-looking flowers in this game, unfortunately. We'll have to get some better ones in the future. And yeah, over here, I was planning to do like a full kitchen and backstage, but that'll have to wait because I wanted to get this out by release day. And over here, we have a little backstage. What it's for, we will find out, but there's also some like trash cans and food stuff. So like if they ever wanted to throw something away for the restaurant, they totally could. And back out from the winery, nothing here has changed, but we get to the main attraction, which is, let me adjust the lighting. There we go, the Otter Creek Challenge Trail. I can't imagine what's in here. But yeah, this is the Otter Creek Challenge Trail. We have these adorable little concrete statues, which are flexicolor, if you weren't aware. And sort of continue the barrel cactus garden. We have a awesome little water tower. So yeah, this is the Challenge Trail. I was thinking kind of along the lines of sort of like a children's zoo in standard terrestrial zoos where they'll have all these super sort of cutesy themed exhibits. There's a lot of different playgrounds and it's a really sort of warm, playful color palette. But yeah, you'll sort of see what I mean as we head inside. So the first exhibit on the left is for plovers, and I was also thinking we'd have ruddy ducks in here as well. And it's pretty standard little aviary. The set is by Jar101293. He does all those dinosaurs, but they also made an amazing little aviary set. I think it's super simple and kind of, yeah, it's very simple. I think it's not as sort of piece expensive as some other aviary sets. And this sort of cute little awning. And then the sort of trend with each one of these exhibits will be, there's the exhibit itself, and then we'll have a little playground sort of themed to that animal. So this is the Piper Pit. It's just a sandbox, but if you look around, you can kind of dig out like sort of rubber crabs and snails and stuff like that, sort of like what sandpipers do. Or in this case, plovers, but plovers are just the type of sandpiper. And yeah, these are by ZZ. He made a huge Japanese spider crab and all these little Maryland blue crabs. And I just thought they made sort of a great sort of theme to the area. I wish we had sort of more nautical themed objects with this new DLC, like maybe like a life preserver and some buoys and stuff like that, but I really can't complain. This has been an amazing pack from what I've seen so far. And over here we have our first glimpse, let me turn on play because these guys like to run around, for the river otters. The games are giant otters, as you can obviously tell, but there are no giant otters in California, so we're just pretending these guys are the North American river otters. He's looking and rolling up there. Let's get a better look at this guy. I won't show too much of what's on the right, but I love these guys so much. There he goes into the water. But yeah, this is their main sort of land area. There's like a little staff door, and then a little door for the otters themselves, which is just the African window, but I think it looks super good as a kind of animal door for the smaller animals towards the backstage. And then yeah, the little otter signs, I love these so much. They're so cute and janky looking, totally what you'd see in like a children's zoo area like this. And yeah, that is the first bit. And then over here, we have the, let's adjust the lighting again. There's so many like changes I have to make with the lighting, but it's definitely worth it if you want to get the best views of everything. So this is the Fisher Falls canopy run. I'm not completely done with it, as you can probably tell looking that way, but we do have the main exhibit, which is a Pacific Fisher, which are like little mustelids, which are actually arboreal, but I kind of wanted to put in a little pond up front. I just thought it looked neat. And yeah, so going up the ladder is the themed playground for the Fishers, which is the canopy run, because these guys do climb trees, and it is a ropes course, much like the Inspiration, which is the Redwood Creek Challenge Trail in Disney's California Adventure. They also have a ropes course. And you just come over here, there's a little net under this bridge, and then this is like a little tower, and I plan for this to go like all the way over this way, but again, I wanted to get this out by today, so we didn't really have time, but that'll be for next episode. And yeah, we'll come down back down the stairs, the little railing, and then over here, get a nice view of Fisher Falls itself. And I went back in last minute and used the waterfalls we got, which are a little weird because it's like a block of stone and just like the waterfall comes out of it. But I think if you can effectively hide it with the rocks we have in game, I think they make for a really nice, sort of more artificial looking waterfall. And then we have this bridge, and the falls continue all the way down and over past Lutra Lumber Co. Oh god, hold on. That's not okay. I put down a trade center for the otters. There we go. That's much better. Real smooth, Wyatt, real smooth. But yeah, this is the Lumber Co. Let me adjust the lighting again, because the sun shines on it amazingly. And this is sort of, this functions as the holding shelter for the otters. If we'll go up. So all of the backstage and shelter for the otters would be in this building, but I just themed it to be sort of a lumber mill, and I absolutely adore how this came out. This is one of my favorite things I've built in this game, especially with the water wheel itself. This was not fun to build. I'll show you how I did it. I took like one, it's the standard sort of spin around circle technique. I just took one part of this and just duplicated it around, and then I just spun it around. I'm answering this very vaguely, but you get it if you've done anything like this. But yeah, it obviously, just because for some reason it didn't line up perfectly, like with the rods and like the just rotation was really finicky, but I don't know. If you don't look at it too hard, it looks perfect in my opinion. Yeah, we have a bunch of, I made this before the pack came out, obviously, so all of these rocks are just temple pieces, but I will definitely be using the flexicolor stones in the future. But I do like how this came out, and then, yeah, if you couldn't tell already, I used the ice slabs, along with some water effects. I'm not too sure why. Well, I get it for this area, just because I wanted a little creek, but I just wanted it to be consistent, like moving around the mill, the lumber mill. And yeah, this is pretty simple, nice little air conditioner. And this is directly based on the Eureka Gold and Timber Co. mill building in California Adventure. Sort of the main inspiration for this whole area was the Grizzly Peak Condor Flats area of that park, which I absolutely adore the theming of. And it's obviously not done. I have all of this to do, but sort of the plan is to extend the ropes course all the way down over here and then have a slide themed to the banana slug, which is a super common insect in California. And it'll be like a big redwood trunk, and then the sort of yellow banana slug slide will come all the way around it. I think it'll be super cool. I'm excited to build that. And then over here, oh boy, what's this? Is the Pepsi-sponsored Otter Passage. Ooh, I built this last night, last minute, but As you can see, the otters use it super frequently, so that's awesome. Look at them go. It's obviously too shallow for them to dive, but I think it sells the look pretty well. I would have loved to see them like diving and like spinning around in this, but unfortunately they couldn't program that. But I really can't complain too hard with this pack. It's been amazing. I love it. I'm excited to do the seals and the penguins and the caiman too. I can't do the penguins and caiman for this area or this park just because everything has to be California, but for future projects, definitely. Especially the LA Zoo, because the LA Zoo has jaguars, tapir, otters, monkeys, and caiman all in one area, so it's pretty much all filled out for me. So, you know, new Griffith Zoo episodes definitely coming soon. But back to the otter passage. I based it on two pieces of concept art. One was a tiger bridge. I forget which zoo, but it was sort of a mesh bridge with the sort of roots sort of encircling all around it, so like a big strangler fig. And then also there was a salmon exhibit that had a very similar color palette with the sort of logs and dark sort of lava rocks, and it was super sort of rustic and charming. But if we look over here, this is... Oh, wait, what? I had no idea this made it over here. I put a dog ball on the land side of it, but it somehow made its way all the way over here. That's crazy. And then, yeah, if you've been paying attention, the signs are sort of consistent. So there's, like, the plover one, the fisher one, and then the otter one. It's just a different color palette for each, but it's the same sort of structure. And, yeah, they can't access this part. In a perfect world, they could, but they just can't traverse these stairs. I feel like they could in real life, but I'm not too sure. I might have to change it. But, yeah, this is the Otter Passage. You can go under, and I'm thinking of adding some terrariums in here. Maybe like a Pacific chorus frog or a collared lizard and stuff like that. But, yeah. You can check out the otters from under here. I'm so excited to do the cinematic for this, because I'll have a ton of fun just sort of following the otters around and getting some cool shots. How you doing, buddy? Yeah, I spent the whole weekend building this whole area, and I am super proud of how it turned out. I'm torn between this and the Australia section, or yeah, this whole build I spent the weekend on. The winery, the vineyard, and then this whole otter area. And I'm torn between this and the work I did in Zooten Towers Islands as sort of my favorite thing that I've built in this game, but I'm just so enamored with all of the theming and the color palette and the gardening. I'm just really proud of it, and I hope you guys like it too. So that'll be all for this episode, but very soon I'll have this area up and running. I'm planning to do like a sardine cannery, and in it will be a exhibit for the gray seals. I don't know if gray seals are native to California. We can actually find out right now with the Zoopedia. Gray seal, gimme. North America and Europe, and yeah, they are on the East Coast, but we'll just have to pretend they're harbor seals because they do look pretty much identical. And it'll be like a sort of harbor seal cannery. So yeah, I'm sorry it's been a while. I just haven't really had the motivation to make videos, but now that this pack is coming out, I definitely will. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.